Hello everyone and welcome to MediSimplified. Today we are going to talk about Mullerian malformations. So Mullerian malformation is basically the anomalies occurring in the Mullerian duct, right? So before knowing the malformation, it is necessary to know that we have two Mullerian ducts, right and left. They both fuse and they form the internal organs of the females. So suppose these are the two Mullerian ducts we have, right and left. They fuse together and then they form the internal organs. Similarly, here we can see we have two ducts. They fuse together at around 10th week of intrauterine life. Then they form the internal organs, which I will be saying you very soon. And in between of this, during the development, there is a septum. We call it as a septa, which resolves after 20 weeks of intrauterine life. So let's go further and see what we have. So this is Mullerian duct. Basic things which we should know: it forms the internal organs in female mostly, and genital organs, right? It appears at 6th week of gestation, and we have two Mullerian ducts, right and left, as I have said you already. So what they form? Right duct will form the following right structure, left will form the following left structure. So the right Mullerian duct will form right fallopian tube, right side of fallopian tube, right side of uterus, right side of cervix, and right side of upper two-third of the vagina, as the vagina develops from the upper two-third of the vagina develops from Mullerian duct. And similarly, the left side of the Mullerian duct will form the corresponding organs, right? Left fallopian tube, left uterus, etc. So what next we have? There is a classification of WHO for this Mullerian malformation. So the class 1 is basically Mullerian agenesis, or we can call it as a Mullerian hypoplasia. After that we have class 2. This all are in Romans. In this slide it is in alphanumerical type, which we use normally, but the classes are written in Roman numbers. So class 1 is Mullerian agenesis. Class 2 is unicornuate uterus. I will be explaining each of them one by one. Then class 3 is didelphys uterus. Class 4 is bicornuate uterus. Class 5 is septate uterus. Class 6 is arcuate uterus. And class 7 is DES associated abnormalities, also called as T-shaped uterus. So let's talk first about Mullerian agenesis. In Mullerian agenesis is what happening? I told you already in the beginning of the video that we have two right and left Mullerian ducts. So in Mullerian agenesis, both these ducts are absent. So what will happen? All the internal organs, all the internal genitalia, which I told you is formed by Mullerian duct, will be absent, right? So both the fallopian tube, right left, will be absent. The whole uterus, whole cervix, and whole upper two-third of the vagina will be absent. But the female will be having the lower one-third of vagina, and that is present just because the lower one-third of vagina develops from the sino-vaginal bulb, not from the Mullerian duct, right? And similarly, the ovaries, they are also not from the Mullerian duct, so they will be also present. So next we will talk about unicornuate uterus. We have a ultrasound, HSG, the hysterosalpingography image with us. So before talking about this image, let's know basically what is unicornuate uterus, which is class 2, if I am not wrong. So unicornuate uterus has Mullerian duct absent on one side. Once again, I will show you right and left, right? So one is absent. So what will happen? All the organs will be formed on one side. So here you can see just one side of the organ is formed, the other side is absent. So one fallopian tube is present, one uterus is, half of the uterus is present, of the side which is present, the side will contain the organs. So half of the uterus, half of the cervix, and upper one third of the vagina are present in the unicornuate uterus. If you see this image, this is how a unicornuate uterus looks in the hysterosalpingograph, that is HSG, which I will be abbreviating in the further videos. Next, we will talk about the didelphys uterus. Now, didelphys uterus is class 3. So, in didelphys uterus, both the duct is present, but they fail to fuse, right? I told you earlier, both ducts fuse together and form the one organ, right? Fallopian tubes are two, but the uterus and cervix is just one in the female. So what is happening in the females with didelphys uterus? These both are not fusing, which used to take at the 10th week of gestation, right? So they are not fusing. So what will happen? They have these two different structures. So they have two uterus, they have two cervix, they have two fallopian tubes, and very importantly, two vagina is present if the patient is having a didelphys uterus. If you look in this image, here you can appreciate there are two parts of the Mullerian duct. So this is two uterus and two cervix, two vagina and two fallopian tubes. If you see properly, there is a very thin fallopian tube visible in this. So going further, now we will talk about bicornuate uterus. Now in bicornuate uterus, both the Mullerian duct is present, but fusion is incomplete. Suppose this is the fusion, it is not fusing completely, it is half fused like this somewhat. So what will happen, the upper structure will be two in number, but the lower structure will be single, right? So both the Mullerian duct are present in bicornuate uterus, but the fusion is incomplete. So if the fusion is incomplete, we have no problem in the fallopian tubes. Whether it fuse or it does not fuse, the normal person will have two fallopian tubes. So it is having two fallopian tubes. The uterus are two, right? The uterus, the upper end will be uterus. So the uterus are two, which is present here, but the cervix is single and vagina is single. So this is how a bicornuate uterus looks like. Two fallopian tube, two uterus, single cervix and single vagina is present. So this is how a HSG of bicornuate uterus looks like. Two uterus we can see, single vagina and single cervix, and two fallopian tube here. Going further, now we will talk about septate uterus. Septate uterus, what is happening? Both the ducta are present, they will fuse, and the septa, which I told is present, it fails to resolve. In the initial, when the video was started, I told you that the septa resolves at 20th week, right? But if the septa will not resolve, the uterus, all the internal organ and the uterus will look normal by outside. If you see this now outside, it is looking normal, but inside it, there is a septate present, due to which we can see two part of uterus in there, and everything rest is normal. It is then, this was about septate uterus. Now let's go further, and we have the arcuate uterus. Now in arcuate uterus also, everything is normal. Usually the uterus is having a dome shape like this, but in the arcuate uterus it is flat. That is the only anomaly present in the arcuate uterus, if I'm not wrong. So everything is normal, just the fundus of the uterus is flat. Normally it is dome shape. You can see here, it is dome shape, it is flat. Normally it should be like this, dome shape. Here also you can see dome flat, it should be dome shape. Fallopian tube is present, cervix and vagina is present. So this was about arcuate uterus. Now let's go further, and DES related anomalies. DES is diethyl stilbestrol, and diethyl stilbestrol related anomalies causes T-shaped uterus. And this is how a T-shaped uterus looks like. Now let's go further. I have discussed all the anomalies with you with the suitable images. Now there are few important one-liners which you should know about the congenital anomalies of Mullerian duct, and then I will show you some images of one single slide of all the images. So important one-liner is, most common Mullerian malformation, it is septate uterus. Fusion occurs, but the septa does not resolve, which should resolve normally in 20th week of gestation. So most common is septate uterus. Second most common is bicornuate uterus. Then for Mullerian anomalies, the investigations of choice. So first investigation, whenever you suspect a female with a Mullerian agenesis or Mullerian any anomalies out of the seven, the first investigation which you do is transvaginal sonography, TVS. And the investigation of choice is 3D ultrasound, and whereas the gold standard for this Mullerian anomalies is MRI. But whenever the patient comes, you get a question, what will be your next step? Always the first investigation should be transvaginal sonography, TVS. Now most common problem due to this different anomalies of Mullerian duct, the uterus is not proper, so the female will have recurrent abortion. What is recurrent abortion? More than three abortions, right? Continuous. So the female will have a recurrent abortion. Now the best reproductive outcome out of all this congenital anomalies, which of the anomaly will have a better outcome, right? There will be no recurrent abortion, less chance of recurrent abortion. it will be in arcuate uterus. Why? Because the arcuate uterus, there is no internal anomaly. Just the dome is not like this. The top is not like dome. It is a flat. So it does not have so much complications as compared to the other anomalies, and it has a better, or I will say best, reproductive outcome out of the all anomalies. And the last is the worst prognosis. Which one of the following you think, out of the following, you think that will have the worst prognosis, that most chance of recurrent abortion? And I will say the female might not be able to have the child in the uterus. So that is the uniconduit uterus, I'm sorry, because there is just one fallopian tube, one uterus, and another side is absent. So it has a worse prognosis. Now here is the image of all the anomalies in short, so that we can review at the end. This is the normal uterus, how it looks like, you can see. Then this is uterine hypoplasia or agenesis. If it is agenesis, nothing will be visible, right? Now next is this uniconduit uterus. In this uniconduit uterus, what will happen? Just one side of the Mullerian duct is present, other side is absent. So the everything will be half and one will be present in number. Then uterus diadelphis, both will be there, but fusion is absent. Both are there, but fusion is absent. So we have two different over there. Then next is biconduit uterus. I have already explained this is how it will look like. Then septate uterus. The septa is not resolving, right? The septa is present till the end in the life also. And then the arcuate uterus, just the dome is, there is no dome shape, it is a flat at the top. And the end diethyl is DES related, so it is a T-shaped uterus. So this is all the images in short of the congenital Mullerian anomalies. So this was all about Mullerian anomalies. Hope you find this video useful. Do share it with your friends, and do follow us on Instagram, Facebook and Telegram. The links are in the description. And do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel, MediSimplified. Thank you.